Thank you, everyone, for coming. Our first speaker of the afternoon is Ankun Beck, who's going to introduce us to OpenGL SC and the differences to OpenGL ES.
Good afternoon. I'm Ankun Beck from Kyobung National University, Korea. And in this afternoon, I will talk about OpenGL SC and focusing on the differences to OpenGL ES. Well, in my talk, this is the center of my talk. I will start the overview of OpenGL SC and scan all the OpenGL SC components. And then, at the functional level, I will show all the API features of OpenGL SC. And then, the closing remarks will be followed. Well, let's start about OpenGL SC overview. OpenGL SC means safety critical features for OpenGL. As currently, we have OpenGL SC version 1.0 and 1.0.1 as an upgrade version. It was originally designed as the target of safety critical avionics and automotive displays, and also targets the minimum drive size and complexity. Another fact is that they also required to certify the DO-178 certification called FAA requirements. This standard is established about 10 years ago, and at the starting time, there was a working group consisting of CMID, Qualcomm, Altsoftware, Dell Aerospace, and other companies. As shown here, these companies are all related to the military embedded systems. So, OpenGL SC was started as a kind of military and avionics specification for the graphics market. And as shown here, the blue-colored companies are currently the member of Columns Group. And so companies are out of Columns Group, but they all certify the OpenGL SC certifications at this time. So, as a historical background, we can see on the left side the typical cockpit system for fighters and some avionics systems are based on the analog systems, as shown on the left side. But nowadays, most cockpit systems are equipped with digital displays, as shown on the right side. To use the digital displays in this cockpit system, they all need some 3D graphics standard to make the digital displays on the cockpit system. And OpenGL SC was originally designed to satisfy this requirement. So, it's a kind of a variation of OpenGL, but satisfies the requirements of the cockpit system. It means that, for example, we met the blue screen during the flight. How about it? For the pilot, the system was cracked down and he can only see the blue screens on the digital displays. One is for him. I think it is a nightmare for him. So, at this time, OpenGL ST focuses on the stability and reliability is also emphasized in this standard. So, it's originally started as OpenGL SC, OpenGL ES safety critical profile. It's a variation of OpenGL ES, but the subgroup immediately found that OpenGL SC must be distinguished from the OpenGL ES. As shown here, they firstly removed some functionalities that is not needed for the military or weapons pack. For example, color conversion, format conversion, and graphic combinations are all removed from the original specification. And then, also, they added some distinguished features such as display list, color palette support, and others to the OpenGL-SE's specification. So nowadays, OpenGL-ES and OpenGL-SE is not compatible anymore. And also, OpenGL-SE was spun out as OpenGL-SE 1.0. Well, globally, OpenGL-SE was based on OpenGL 1.3. Yes, and at this time it's actually all the specification of OpenGL, but it is done. What I've shown in latest slides, OpenGL ES 1.0 is also based on OpenGL 1.3. So at the root level, OpenGL ES 1.0 and OpenGL SC 1.0 is based on the same standard. And it also has some distinguished features. For example, begin and paradigm is only used in OpenGL SC, not OpenGL ES. And also, display support and color palette support is also only supported in OpenGL SC, not OpenGL ES, OpenGL. And nowadays, we also have some issues specific on OpenGL SC. For example, nowadays we need OpenGL SC 1.0 conformal test shoes. It will be prepared. It is now ready for release, and also there are some needs for the next version of OpenGL SC. Well, in this October, there was a face-to-face meeting in close group, and they expected another version of OpenGL SC, and well, but at this time they did not decide what is the next version of OpenGL SC. It may be 1.1 or 2.0. It's still not decided, and the working group will be started in near future. Well, historically, OpenGL 1.3 was used as a basis for OpenGL ES 1.0 and also OpenGL SC 1.0. And later, OpenGL 1.5 is used for OpenGL ES 1.1. This is the previous standard for OpenGL ES market. And later, OpenGL 2.0 and some extra features became the basis for OpenGL ES 2.0. This is the final specification of the OpenGL ES market. And nowadays, we also have the next version of OpenGL ES. Is also known as a Halti, or OpenGL ES 3.0. It is based on OpenGL 3.0, or OpenGL 4.0 is also used for this Halti project. It will be announced in next year. And then, next topic is that OpenGL ST conference. It's a bird's eye view for the OpenGL ST conference. Well, the core of OpenGL ST standard is that the 101 functions for core features of OpenGL is selected from original OpenGL 1.3 and used for making some distinct features for OpenGL and safety critical features here. And it's also supposed to begin the paradigm and geoport test functions and also display support. It is some distinctive features from OpenGL ES. Similar to OpenGL ES, it also has some extensions. The first one is that core edition of single crystal extension. It was just the same to the its corresponding OpenGL ES extension. It's also named the single crystal extension in OpenGL ES. In this extension, there are four functions: depth range, cluster, orthogonal, and clear depths. As you can see, in original OpenGL, all these four functions are based on the double reflection time. But in OpenGL ES and OpenGL SC, all these functions are converted to floating point types, as shown here. Well, this is very simple to support these features. domestic feature is the budget texture. It's a distinctive feature for OpenGL-ES. Budget texture is that originally, the usual texture is defined as the two colors, using for RGBA channels as a 4x4 1 pixel. But in budget texture, a 1-byte index is used for defining the texture, as the color in this texture is defined, and then its corresponding color table, also known as palette, is used to make the original texture. To support this budget texture extension, we need the color index 8 extension for texturing functions, and also some extra features are needed for image functions, and also we need 4 extra functions for color palette setups. Another one, the final optional extension is the Shorts Texture Palette. This extension can be used as a to support to use a single texture palette for several textures. With this extension, several textures can share a single texture palette. Well, to support this extension, we need to modify several functions, core functions, and also some color table related functions. Well, at this time, we have some technical issues with OpenGL-C. In comparison with OpenGL-ES, it has some extra features for support budget texture. And a big problem with this budget texture is that in the commercial market, there is no graphics card supporting these extensions anymore. In the case of NVIDIA, all the GeForce 5 series can support these functions, but that's the oldest one. And at this time, NVIDIA does not support anymore. Also, in the case of ATI or newly MVMD, the graphics chips does not support any current palette-related functions anymore. So, conclusively, we need a new implementation to support OpenGL-C in software or in hardware. It depends on the implementation. From now on, I will show the API features of OpenGL-C at the function level. In this point, now, as you can see, you can see the section numbers of these slides. These section numbers correspond to the original OpenGL 1.3 section numbers. So starting from this 2.5 from these sections, I will show every API features in the OpenGL-C. In the case of GL error functions, everything is supported except the table to large error. It is not used in OpenGL SC or OpenGL ES. The next level, well, originally OpenGL has several JavaScript primitives, but as in OpenGL ES, OpenGL SC does not support any polygons or quadruples, so they are removed, and only points and lines and triangles are supported in the JavaScript primitives. So as shown here, we have the drawing primitive of glBegin and glEnd paradigm. Yeah. Well, this beginning and paradigm is supported in OpenGL, but does not support it in OpenGL ES, so it's distinguished from the OpenGL ES. In the case of vertex specification, there are many functions in original OpenGL specification, but only the floating point version is supported in OpenGL-C. And in the case of vertex arrays, we also have only the floating point versions. And in contrast, in OpenGL-ES, they also have some integer version and short integer version in these primitives. And the draw primitive says draw less and draw less. They are very similar to the Fontanians, so there's no comment on it. And in the case of coordinate transformations, these all functions are correspond to OpenGL ES 1.1 features, and just the same to the OpenGL ES 1.1 features. Only one exceptional case is that there is no texture matrix in the case of OpenGL C. But OpenGL ES uses these texture matrix functions. And then, next is that the commas and the coloring functions. In the case of OpenGL C, they only support the front and back faces. So we cannot define the separated front feature and back face feature in this standard. In some sense, it's a limited feature, but OpenGL SC only supports two light sources and no spotlight. In some sense, as a user of OpenGL, we can believe that it's two weak features. But originally, OpenGL SC was designed to support the digital displays in cockpit, so they do not need spotlight or generalized lighting features in digital displays. So they only need to write sources and those who write. And similarly, there is no two-sided writing and some colorful materials supported, but some colorful materials supported are used in OpenGL C. And in the case of interlacing, there is no multi-sampling support. This is supported in OpenGL C, obviously yes, but does not support anymore in OpenGL C. It's the same region. OpenGL C is used for display the digital displays in the cockpit, so interlacing is not required at this time. And in the case of point primitives, in the case of OpenGL C, they only support point size 1 is allowed in this feature. In the case of line primitives, all the functions are very similar to the OpenGL ES, but additionally, OpenGL C supports line stipples in its specification. So, line stipples are used in OpenGL C. And similarly, polygon stipples are also supported in OpenGL C. And in the case of texturing functions, in OpenGL ST, only on-site byte textures are allowed. So there is no other data types in defining the texture services. So as shown here, only these combinations are allowed to define any texture images. It's very limited features in OpenGL ST. And in the case of texture images, they only support 2D textures. It's somewhat very different from OpenGL ES. Nowadays, OpenGL ES supports 2D textures and 3D textures are allowed. But OpenGL C only supports 2D textures. So many texturing functions are limited to 2D textures only. Another difference to OpenGL C and OpenGL ES is that there is no memory release functions in texture functions and also the display release functions as shown in later. That means that OpenGL C has no garbage collection feature or any kind of memory release feature in its standard. Well, I think that this restriction is introduced to make the system more stable. As you know, within the garbage collection feature, the system may be paid to support the real-time features. So in the 4GLS C, there is no memory reallocation or memory release in its original specification itself. So there's in the case of texture functions, there is no direct texture function anymore. And also in the texture mount support, there are only limited support, as shown here, baud rate, replace, decal, blend, and add functions are supported. But combined texture environment is not supported in OpenGL-SC. In the case of fork, there is no fork support anymore in OpenGL-SC. It is also different from OpenGL-ES. And the next functions are related to the frame buffer functions. This block diagram is very simplified diagram for OpenGL ES and OpenGL, original OpenGL frame buffer functions. As shown here, we need a scissor test, alpha test, stencil test, depth test, and blending, and dithering, and logical operations. In the case of OpenGL ES, they support all these functions. But in the case of OpenGL-SC, there is no dithering, and also there is no logical operations anymore. And in the case of alpha test, depth test, and the blending functions, many deleted features are supported only, not fully supported in the OpenGL-SC. Let's see. At first, the scissor functions, and in the case of alpha test, all the functions in the case of alpha test, only limited features are supported in OpenGL-SC. And next, stencil buffers are actually used in many graphics programs. But in the case of stencil buffer, as shown here, OpenGL-SC supports alpha features as shown in OpenGL-ES. Okay, then in the case of blending functions, these blending features are used to mix the source features and also some frame of pixels with the newly generated pixel values to mix the final result. But in the case of OpenGL-SC, only linked functions are supported in these blender functions. Very conclusively, as shown here, when at first we have fully supported scissor functions, but only limited alpha functions, as shown here, less than equal or always are supported. That's it. And in the case of test functions, we only have less than equal or always flex. All other values are not supported in OpenGL-SC. It's a very limited feature. And in the case of blending functions, there are only three combinations are allowed. As shown here, source alpha and 1 minus source alpha and others. These all three combinations are allowed in OpenGL-SC. So, very limited blending functions are supported in OpenGL-SC. And other whole frame framework functions are just fully supported as shown in OpenGL-ES. Actually, the framework functions are summarized here. And we also support the full support for scissor test and extension test, but partial support for alpha test and depth test and random functions. But there's no support for design and logical operations. Okay, the point is that, as shown here, we have full support for scissor functions, but partial support for alpha functions, I showed you, as an equal and always a support only supported. And we can see, similarly, in the case of dense functions, it only supports less than equal and always plus, and all of the values are equal to them. And in the case of a blending function, all three combinations are only supported in what we can see. It's a very limited feature. The whole frame of functions are just the same to the function ES, so there is no comment at this time. We also have some less than partial functions. It is not supported in the function ES. It's used for GLP map function and draw pixels and cut pixels. In the case of pre-map functions, actually, OpenGL ES only supports RGBA images, but in the case of OpenGL SC, it also supports the black part image as the name of VMAP, and it's different from OpenGL ES. In the case of pixels, we also support linear pixels and copy pixels. In the case of OpenGL ES, there is no function corresponding to copy pixels. But the OpenGL-C supports this function. And for the display list, it's originally used in OpenGL, but excluded from OpenGL-ES. But the OpenGL-SC also supports this display list. And as the same as the texturing functions, due to the memory problems, it also supports. It does not support the release of the allocated list as shown here, so there is no delete list function in OpenGL SC. Okay. Crash and fish was to be supported in OpenGL standard. Some hint functions are also supported, but in the case of OpenGL SC, it is only hints, so they cannot support any features in any implementation. Some calling functions, it is also used in the OpenGL ES and the original OpenGL. And in the case of extensions, as I already mentioned, the simple Christian extension only supports for four functions for floating point versions, and it is just the same to the OpenGL ES. So that's it. Validated texture functions is they need the newly developed pipeline for the texturing. So this is a kind of validated texture support for OpenGL SC pipelines. And to support these functions, we need some extensions for texturing this 2D function and others. Also, to define the color table, we need some new functions in comparison with the OpenGL ES. And the final optional extension of the shared texture palette, we need a little extensions for many functions. For example, all the quality functions and all the color table related functions must be extended to support this optional extension. And now is the final closing remarks. As a summary, in this talk, I present the OpenGL SC safety critical profile, and it is based on OpenGL 1.3, and very similar to the OpenGL ES 1.1, but it also has some distinctive features. As summarized, it has the begin at the paradigm, display list, and texture palettes. Is all distinct features of OpenGL SC. And at this time, OpenGL SC requires a new version of 1.1 or 2.0 is required. And also, some conformance test past implementations are expected in the near future, and it will be used widely for the safety critical market. Okay. That's it. Is the end of my talk. Is there any questions? No questions? Okay, that's good.